Good morning, I'm David Brenner. I'm the Amaranth Curator here in Ames, Iowa for the National Plant Germplasm System, and we're talking about grain amaranths today. Grain amaranths are really three species, all derived from the wild species Amaranthus hybridus. So there are a lot of other amaranths besides the grain amaranths, but the grain amaranths have small white seeds that are used in the health food trade, and there's a kind of boom in amaranth grain production now, mostly from India, exported from India and used in lots of gluten-free products. Most of them, the germplasm for grain amaranths mostly comes from the tropics, which has different day lengths. So here in the temperate zone, they tend to grow a bit taller than you'd want them to, and plant breeders have been working on making them shorter. I'm showing you some white seeds here mixed in with the reddish flower parts. And there are also lots of black-seeded amaranths, especially the weeds. This dark wine red is very similar to what's used in the trade for sprouts, and it's a regular production kind that you can buy. You can buy garnet red easily online. But here I'm using it as a male fertile plant next to these male sterile plants. So there's two different colors of male sterile plants. These plants, the orange and the white one, are all cytoplasmic male sterile, all sterile, no pollen, and that means that all the seeds they produce are hybrids, because the pollen comes from the red plants onto the orange and the white plants, and then the progeny in the next generation should be all red, because they all have that red father, and they should all be hybrids, F1 hybrids. And this is about how hybrid seeds are produced in a great many crops, especially onions, sorghum, sunflowers. So figuring out these relationships for cytoplasmic male sterile hybrid seed production is one of our many tasks here in classifying and improving amaranths for world plant breeders, and it could someday result in major improvements. The properties of grain amaranth that make it of great interest in the future are that it has a very high quality protein, both in the seeds and in the foliage, but the protein, it has all the amino acids, so the protein quality is very similar to eggs. And this is unlike corn and many other crops. They have lots of protein, but they're missing crucial amino acids. So if your diet includes a little bit of amaranth and the staple crops that you're already accustomed to, you come out okay. And for that reason, it's been very strongly promoted, especially in East Africa, where people have corn-based diets and are starving. But with a little bit of amaranth, the diets improve dramatically, children health improves dramatically, huge progress, improvements in people's lives. And this is actually happening in East Africa. In addition to that, it's much more drought tolerant than most of the main crops. It has trouble germinating in dry weather, but once it germinates, it's got a relatively quick cycle, and it's able to mine water from far deeper than most of the crops. So it's going almost 2 meters down to get water out of the soil, and that allows it to survive droughts that would destroy other crops. In extreme droughts, the amaranth will grow shorter, but it will still mature a crop, whereas the main commodity crops will just fail. So it has substantial advantages. The disadvantages that need to be overcome before amaranth is more consumed are mostly fitting it into recipes and food formulation more, which is actually happening. It's a major international traded commodity for the agronomy side, which is not really the problem. It's possible to make incremental plant breeding progress so the plants are less likely to fall over, which is called lodging, and less likely to drop their seeds on the ground, which is called shattering. And there are plant breeders working on all these things, and the F1 hybrids that I'm talking about, I think, could improve the crop. But mostly it's a matter of food formulators fitting it into diets, and it has a good, secure place in those diets because it's gluten-free and it improves nutrition dramatically. There are some gaps in the plant germplasm collection of amaranths. We have most of the wild species. I personally have collected just about all the wild species in the United States, and most of them are not weeds. There's some very problematic weeds, but most of them are just wild species that stay in their native habitat. and we've collected just about all of them in the United States, with rare exceptions.